Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be showing everyone how to use the Testic PA5840 with the EM Test PFM 200 and 100 up there at the top, as well as the EM Test Autoway, which you'll find all the way at the top up there, to conduct OEM LV124 pulses. Specifically, we're going to focus on pulse E10, which is a short reset. This setup, as well as the application note, which is application note 218, will be available in the description. So you can go ahead and check that out by clicking on the link in the description. So we're gonna go ahead and we'll first walk through how to do some of the connections, connecting our PA5840 right there at the bottom with our PFM, following that with our EM Test Autowave to be sure everything is connecting. We'll do that with the front and the back of the equipment. Following that, we'll show you how to set up the software to be sure everything on the software is good and everything's communicating. And then following that, we'll run a couple quick pulses just to verify that we are getting out what we believe we are with our oscilloscope. So let's go ahead and we'll start with some of the connections to the front of the equipment. All right, so here you're gonna find the front side of your Testic PA5840, your EM Test PFM 200N, and then your EM Test Autowave. So the connection we want to need to make here today is gonna be from your voltage in, which you'll see right here on your PA5840. That's just gonna be a BNC connector. That just turns on right there. And this connector is going to go to the backside of your EM Test Autowave, which is going to be up here at the top. Another connection you will have to make as well, and this is going to be your output. So this is going to be right below kind of the interface right here in the display. You'll see your negative and positive. And so we do have a corresponding connector right there. We're just going to go ahead and connect to positive and then to negative. All right, and these connections are just going to go to the backside of your PFM 200N, which we'll show you in just a minute. A lot of these cables are going to be included with the test system, so you don't really have to worry about those. You just have to be able to identify them and know where everything needs to be connected. Okay, so now let's go ahead and let's turn around and I'll show you how to make some connections to the backside of some of this equipment. Okay, so here you're going to find the backside of your EM Test Autowave, PFM 200N, and Testic PA5840. So let's go ahead and start making some of the connections you're going to need to do to get everything operational. The first one, we're going to go ahead and we're going to go take the BNC connector that was connected to the front side of our PA5840. We're going to go ahead and connect it to channel one today. You can use other channels. However, today we have everything set up for channel one. Following that, you do need to do your power going from your PA5840 to your PFM 200N. So we're going to go ahead and do the positive and the negative. You do need communication from your EM Test Autowave to your PFM 200N. So you'll see frame bus in, frame bus out. So this guy has to go from your EM Test Autowave to your PA5840. The connection is right here. You will see the out is terminated. So you want to be sure that is terminated, that there is something in there to stop that. So we're just going to go ahead and connect that in there today. All right, we're good to go. So one thing you obviously want to be aware of as well is you will see connectors for the power going to each individual equipment, both the EM Test Autowave, the PFM 200N, and then down there, I'm not sure you can see it with your Testic PA5840. There is one more connection you want to be aware of as well. That's going to be your Ethernet right here. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to connect that right in there today. And that's just going to allow you to control everything via the ISO.control software. Okay, so that should be about it for connections. We're really not too concerned with the backside of the Testic PA5840. These connections are already good to go, so you really shouldn't have to do much there. Let's go ahead and start up the software and walk through how to get everything configured through that. Okay, so now we're going to show everyone how to set up your Autowave.control software. If you are renting the EM Test Autowave from us here at Transient Specialist, we'll provide a USB stick that's going to have your serial number and some other information available on there. Otherwise, if you guys are out there and you purchase the system, that should be available for you as well. Keep in mind as we're walking through this video, especially the software today, that we did purchase the additional fast switching license. So should you be following along, you're looking to do some of these pulses, just be sure you go out there and get that as well. So you will notice a couple different things about the software here, just taking a quick look at it. We're going to go ahead and start a lower right-hand corner, operation mode offline. So you see that right now is offline. You will see our PFM, followed by that our Autowave. So we're going to walk through the setup here in this first portion. So let's go to setup and device. So as I mentioned before, right now it is offline. However, we're going to show you as if you are setting this up for the first time. So now go ahead and go to select system configuration. And today we're using system 6, which is going to be your Autowave plus your external source. We're going to add the PFM 200 as well. So we're going to go ahead and click OK. We already have that entered here, but you can see that if you didn't
that's how you would do it. If you look over here, output channel one, as we spoke about previously, we have that BNC connector going from our PA5840. This is going to our channel one for our EM test auto wave. So you see that indicated there. Our LAN right here, this is another area you want to pay attention to. Our host address is 10.0.0.2. So you do want to see that right here. And our device address is typically going to be one less or one more than that. So typically, that's how it will go. Today, ours is 10.0.0.3. Okay, so you'll see our source right here. And we entered our PA5840 information right here. You'll see our PA5840. You will see our source type, our min voltage, and our max frequency. Those are all going to be determined by our PA5840. One area you really do want to be aware of is that's going to be your input limits, so your max voltage. If you're referencing the LV124 application note, should be application note 213, I believe, it specifies the max voltage for your input limit as a way to communication with your EM test autowave. So it has to be this 8.57142 volts, or you're going to have issues. So just be sure you enter that correctly. And then following that, we'll be using our PFM today. So we entered that information in here as well. If that doesn't pop up for some reason, you can go ahead and go to Add Device. You can select PFM from the list. You'll see it right there. We already have ours added, so we're not going to add that today. Now, one thing you do want to be sure you're doing, too, is you do want to enter the serial numbers. Be sure you're providing as much information as you can. That way, you're sure it runs smoothly. All right. So it looks like we're all entered here, so we're happy. We have all the addresses entered correct. We have our channels lined up. Serial numbers are entered. We're good to go. So we're going to select OK now. And now we're going to switch. So right now it says offline. You will see the PFM and autowave indicated. We're going to go ahead and switch that to online. All right, let's give it a second to kind of load everything up. Okay, so taking a look here, a little menu popped up. Set up EUT power. So this is going to be kind of an important step here. So we're going to set the power supply as on. This is going to allow you to kind of calibrate your power supply with the software. So what you can do is you look at the front side of your PA5840, and let's say we don't have this voltage offset. This is just calibrating it, saying, hey, my voltage supply is reading a little bit less or more than what's going in. And it's going to allow you to be a little more accurate, with your testing. So just be sure you are following that process. And when you're ready to go, all you have to do is hit set. Okay, so once everything is all set up, you should look in the lower right-hand corner. You should see your PFM and your autowave both being green. Okay, so that should be just about it for the autowave.control software. Let's go ahead and start doing some different testing, and then we'll verify everything with our oscilloscope. Okay, so we got everything communicating and the system up and running. You will see here online, PFM, and autowave. So we're good to go. Now let's go ahead and open some of the standards. So here's kind of the main interface you'll see right here, open test standards. All right, let's scroll to the top here. Let's close these folders. Okay, so here's a couple different predefined kind of standards groupings, automotive, aviation, and military. Today, we're really only concerned with automotive. And this is going to be under the manufacturer folder because we're concerned with OEM LV124. So let's go under manufacturer. All right, scroll down. We're going to go to OEM. You see it already indicated there. Let's say OEM LV124. You'll see it right there. You'll see we selected 2013, 12-volt system. And we're looking for Pulse E10. The reason why we're doing Pulse E10 today is it does utilize all three of these pieces of equipment. We're going to go ahead and we're going to do test case one, 10 microseconds to 100 microseconds. And when we selected the pulse we wanted, we just hit the select button right there. Okay, here you're going to find the main interface for the different pulses that this system is capable of providing. You will see here, on the left side, a couple different little toggle menus up here at the top left corner, as well as some options here. It does provide a wide variety of different modifications that can be done from this screen. However, today, we're really just going to verify that everything is set up correctly and that we are getting what we think we should be getting out of the test system. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and click on step. And you'll see here some of the different criteria of these pulses. You got the different timing here. So we're going to keep the TD at 10 microseconds. This is just going to add 10 microseconds to the duration of every pulse, and that is going to allow us to easily verify that with our oscilloscope. Now let's go ahead and run it, and let's take a look at the oscilloscope and verify our pulses are coming in at 10 microseconds greater at every pulse we capture on the oscilloscope.
Okay, so all we've done so far is connected the output from our test generator to our oscilloscope through the high voltage differential probe. Now we're going to go ahead and verify some pulses quickly. We do have our oscilloscope set for 10 microseconds per division, and we have our DT at 10 microseconds. So each pulse will increase by 10 microseconds as we go through all three of them. So let's go ahead and hit start on our software. We'll go ahead and monitor the screen. All right, that's our first pulse, looks good. And there's our second pulse, also looks good. And following that, we'll just verify our third pulse real quick. All right, perfect. Three divisions, we're good to go. Okay, that's just about wrap it up for today. We appreciate everyone's time, and feel free to let us know if you have any other questions or if you're ever looking to rent any of these automotive test systems used for OEM LV124 testing. Thank you.